Charge controller. Overall view of the solar system, DC switches and bus bars are discussed in previous videos. Now is the time to introduce the charge controller. In this video, we will be talking about solar charge controllers. Here are the topics that we will be discussing in this video. Solar charge controller is one of the main components of the off-grid solar system. Simply, it manages charging the battery bank. Charge controller is a voltage or current regulator which ensures a healthy charge profile for the batteries and protect them from overcharging. Solar charge controller goes between the solar panels and the battery. There are mainly two types of solar charge controllers: pulse width modulation or PWM charge controllers and maximum power point tracking or MPPT charge controllers. For this installation, we have chosen an MPPT charge controller. MPPT charge controller tracks the output of solar array and adjusts the charging voltage and current so that the obtained energy from the batteries is always maximized. The overall performance of an MPPT charge controller is usually up to 30% more than its similar PWM counterpart. What is also great about MPPT charge controllers is that they can accept higher input voltages from the PV array and turn the voltage to current to increase the charging performance of the solar system. Here, the simplified schematic of an MPPT charge controller is presented. The main principle is to get electrical energy from solar panels and provide the most efficient charge profile for the batteries. The sampling circuit gathers the information from the solar system and sends data to MCU. The MCU, as the brain of the structure, controls the whole circuits and manages several tasks such as collecting info, running search algorithms, checking the battery status, and providing functional electrical commands. According to the state of the charge of the battery and the PV array input, maximum power point is determined by the MCU, and the driver circuit is used to provide the optimum amount of the charging voltage and current for the batteries. Batteries are not always charged with the same profile. Multi-stage charging function is usually provided in an MPPT system to adjust the charging profile with the battery's state of charge. This ensures the battery's health and prolongs its life. Let's now look at the charge controller itself. You can see 5 buttons, 3 LED indicators, 6 terminals, a temperature sensor input, and RS-485 port. There are 3 pairs of terminals at the bottom of MPPT charge controller. The first pair is employed to connect the solar array's positive and negative terminal. The second pair is dedicated to connect the battery to the charge controller. And the third pair connects the DC load to the charge controller. But why we need a temperature sensor? MPPT charge controllers are smart devices, and as we know, heat degrades the efficiency of an electrical system. So, temperature sensors are employed in charge controllers to avoid extra high or low temperatures. For instance, lithium batteries are involved with explosions in the temperatures below zero. So the charge controller manages the proper operation by temperature sensor. Now, let's introduce the controller buttons of the MPPT charge controller. PV button demonstrates the voltage, current, power, and cumulative energy stored. Bat button illustrates the voltage, current, temperature, and the state of the charge of the battery. load button demonstrates the voltage, current, energy, consumed energy, and different modes of DC loads, respectively. Set button is employed to change the display style of the parameters, and together with the power ESC button, it is also used to enter and exit the setting interface of the controller for setting parameters. There is a separate video about parameter settings of the MPPT controller, which you can find in our channel. Here, you can see different types of charge controllers, both MPPT and PWM. Some controllers are also designed modular so that they can be used according to their specific applications. It should be noted that all types of the charge controllers employ same standard terminal configurations. However, some models have different terminals. Monitoring. LCD is not the only device which monitors the charge controller parameters. Using the RS-485 port, there are lots of devices and choices which provide means for monitoring. Here are some of those devices. Remote meter or MT50, data logger, Bluetooth adapter, and Wi-Fi adapter. RS-485 port also enables to get connected with the mobile and PC. In next videos, we will learn more about how to connect and use each device in more details.